Welcome to the Sonny B. Shepherd Memorial Gymnasium here at Delone Catholic High School in McSherrystown. We're going to have the wrestling match between the Delone Squires and the Biglerville Canners. But first, we're going to do the Parents' Night, well, it used to be Parents' Night, now the Senior Night Ceremony for our wrestlers. We have four of them. I'm not sure the order, but it'll be Tate Needer, Nate Hart, Nick Carpenter, and Ryder Rekart.
Yeah.
While we're waiting here, I'm Bill Smith. I have my wife Danny doing all the tech stuff, and we have Tony Weaver here as well.
Yeah, I'm going to make an appearance at a wrestling match, and wrestling is not my strong suit. So tomorrow night, though, we have a big matchup with Delone Catholic and Littlestown Thunderbolts. Delone boys on a roll here. They have they're 6-7. They are on the cusp of might make the 2A districts. But they're going to have to win four of their last five games, and tomorrow night's a huge match against Littlestown. So we'll come on the air probably a little bit before six tomorrow night, right, Danny? We have JV.
Yeah, JV will be six. So a little bit before six we'll start.
And we'll have Mike Knoll here tomorrow night to do some color. Bill will move over and do the camera. Danny, as always, will be doing all the tech work. This is my first chance to see the wrestlers this year. We did a couple matches last year. I think you did two already this year, Bill.
Yeah, we did. Now, Fairfield was only two matches.
Yeah.
And there was I think it was Littlestown. They had a pretty full squad, so there was a pretty full match that we've done as well. But I anticipate Biglerville to have a pretty full team.
Yeah, well, it looks like Delone has enough wrestlers. They got four over there and about 11 or 12 over there at the bench. Biglerville hasn't come out yet. Yeah, I should have had my daughter Janelle come up and do this. She knows more about wrestling than I do. She was a college trainer at Millersville and up at Lock Haven for the wrestling teams. Two fine PSAC schools that wrestle. And she actually helped out here as a trainer when she was here with the wrestling team here at Delone. So she would know a lot more going on than me.
Hey, welcome her up anytime.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah, anything. It looks like they're working to get started.
Yeah, Coach Giraffe is trying to get things organized down there. Next week, I guess you'll have to listen to social media. I know we got York Catholic basketball on Friday night, the boys. And you said Tuesday night we got a wrestling match.
Yeah, I think there was a match that was a Camp Hill. We were going to go to Camp Hill on Wednesday, and that's been rescheduled for Tuesday night here. So we plan on bringing that to you as long as everything stays as we expect it to.
And we're pretty sure about the basketball game Friday night. But other than that, things are up in the air. I guess there's a lot of rescheduling going on. And so once we get it, somebody will post it on Facebook or somewhere that the Delone Catholic site will post it, and we'll know what's going on.
Well, assuming everything, we get everything in this week. Last night was a rescheduled game, too, so I think we might be called up.
Please direct your attention to the mat as we honor our senior athletes.
And now we're going to start the senior night ceremony. First is Nick Carpenter.
He's been a varsity wrestler for 4 years. His other school activities include 4 years on the golf team and 3 on the baseball team. His future plans include to start in a pre-med program and attend medical school and focus on orthopedics.
that Nick has an injured wing there.
Yeah, several weeks he's had. So he hasn't been able to. Second wrestler is Nate Hart.
Tate Dieter.
Now we have Tate Dieter.
Dale Schubert and Steve Dieter. Tate has wrestled for 4 years. His other school activities include 4 years on the football team. His future plans include to attend Maritime College in New York City.
And her last wrestler is Ryder Lee Ricard.
Ryder Lee has wrestled for 2 years. His other school activities include 2 years on the golf team, 1 year of basketball, and 2 competing in track and field. His future plans include to graduate from Mount St. Andrews University. Let's have another round for all our seniors.
And there we have our senior wrestlers. We're honoring especially the parents for all the running and fetching and changing schedules and buying things. And
most of these kids have probably wrestled since they were 5 or 6 years old, like most of the other sports, and there's a lot of weekends away from home. And
yeah, wrestling does tend to start really young.
Yeah, it's good you say about the parents, because these senior nights are not just about their time here at the Lone Catholic. It's, you know, all the other things that came up when they come up through, especially wrestling, he said, starts at 5 or 6. It's a cumulant, you know, of everything that happened. Well, DeLone's out here in the mat. We're waiting for Biggerville to take the mat, I guess.
Yeah, I'm assuming they were waiting.
I think Coach Giraffe is going to take the team back to the wrestling room now. And Biggerville will probably come out and do their warm-ups here shortly. You know what? I don't even see a referee yet, unless we didn't go through the weigh-ins yet. Probably they already did that.
I imagine they've already done that. I know when, and once we get, well, I don't think they're even going the whole way back. Looks like they're just
going to stay there
in the
until
Bigger
Girl comes out. I once thought the weigh-ins had to be an hour before, but maybe I might be wrong on that. From my year in high school, they doing that because I'm here.
Well, no, their taste is pretty eclectic. They go all the way from Johnny Cash to other classic rock to rap. Yeah, the wrestling team's always been.
Well, Bill, it looks like we had 13 wrestlers out there for the loan, so that's going to be one down. I don't know how many Biggerville bought. Well, they can play this all night for me. This guy.
Probably would have made for a better Super Bowl halftime.
You one of the people that were hoping the weekend was over.
No, I actually got down to Mom and Dad's to take out the trash during garbage or during the during the garbage show.
So we're still waiting for the canners out here, and like Bill said, DeLone's going to be in black singlets. I think probably Biggerville has black too.
The last I saw, I don't know if it was last year or the year before, but when Biggerville came here last, they had almost identical singlets. Which between now the headgear, the mask, and the singlet may make it a little difficult to tell who's who.
Well, it's going to be impossible for me. Probably some of these kids in class.
Yeah, I've had a handful of them. All and the seniors I've had.
Correct me if I'm wrong. They wear masks here also for wrestling.
Yeah. Yeah, it's the kind of thing I think they. As they're wrestling, if it comes down, they leave it. But as soon as action stops, you know, as soon as it goes out of bounds or something, they'll reapply them.
My guess is Biggerville's probably warming up in the wrestling room, and then they'll come right out on the mat here. Been a long week here at Sonny Shepherd Gym, and tomorrow night we have another event. It'll be 5 out of 5 this week, and we should be called up, I think.
Because I know last night's was a makeup from a week or two ago. And we did, you know, assuming tomorrow goes, we will have made every.
Right, because the girls are going to be at the Littlestown playing them. And we'll be having the boys' contest here.
And that, I think, is pretty commendable for the schools to, you know, the flexibility of, especially the athletic directors. I know it takes a lot of coordination.
Yeah, I'm sure they're on the
communication,
phone.
Communication, yeah.
Especially with COVID and the weather that's been thrown our way here and probably still coming in the next couple days. They're probably on the phones constantly trying to arrange things. And I think it showed a little bit this week as some of the basketball teams looked like they just didn't have their legs under them like they should this time of year because they've been playing so many games.
Yeah, the season certainly has been compressed because there wasn't anything until about the 10th of January.
Right, we're only about a month into the season, and both these teams, both girls and guys, have played 13 games.
But, you know, some of that also has to do with the precautions they use. I know when we were setting up here, they were, you know, the wrestlers and the coaches were coming out, and the coaches, you know, sprayed disinfectant on the mat and wiped it in and up across the mat. So there's a new process that they're learning and everybody's taking seriously. So.
Well, it looks like 15 bodies out there. One looks like a female here for Biggerville. What's that going to be? Bill, you know the rules here. It'll be a wrestle. We'll wrestle or we're going to have to forfeit that?
Diocesan rule is that we don't have any of our wrestlers wrestle intergender, so we'll just forfeit that particular match.
If they put her out. Yeah.
Right.
But we're starting at 106. I'm not sure. I guess we're starting. Now hold it. They changed it to 160. We're going to start at 160. I wish the announcer would tell us who's on the mat.
Well, it was going to be.
And they do these singlets are almost identical. Right.
I think that's Isaac Roth. But there is a stripe in the
The bigger girl has a gold stripe, so.
But we begin the first.
And I take it this is the match. It's not an exhibition match, I would take it.
No, any junior high or JV stuff has been. We're not doing that this season.
So this is the actual match starting
here. Yeah, this is actual varsity, yep. Well, we're almost a minute in. No scoring still. Feeling each other out. Just about, I think. We have a takedown now by DeLone. Working to try to get up under the arm, maybe for a half.
So people watching on DCBN here, the match score will be in green, I take it, and the match score will be in red. The individual match score will be beside what weight it is in green.
Yeah, the team score is in red, and the individual match score is going to be in green. Down to 30 seconds left. They're getting close to the end of the or edge of the. Yeah, I'm thinking we're getting close to a stall. Even though he's. I think he might be doing just enough to keep. Okay, looks like DeLone chooses to start from the down position.
Yeah, red won the flip, that which is bigger reel there, and they deferred.
Usually, especially an experienced wrestler will choose to go from the down position because it's a statistically at least easy point to get either an escape or a reversal.
So he got an escape and then a takedown for a 5-0 lead for the DeLone wrestler. Looks like he's working on a cradle here. My limited knowledge of what's going on.
Yeah, he's trying to get under the right leg there. Now.
Now I think you're more likely to maybe get a stall call because they're in the middle of the mat here. Biggerville got a point for potentially dangerous or something like that.
I'm not sure. I think
the ref went behind his head, which.
Yeah, I think it was bending the arm back. I'm not sure exactly what. But down with less than a minute left in the second period. Score still 5-1 in favor of DeLone.
Looks like he's going to turn him.
He's getting close. He has 30 seconds to get it.
Ref now starting a.
Yeah, he's getting some back points. Even if he doesn't get a, it looks like he's not going to.
See how many back points he gives him here. Can he give him two? Yes.
Yeah, two back points, so we'll be at 7-1 as the time wanes down on the second period. Well, after starting in a down position, I think Isaac was in control for most of the round there.
Now the ref's going over to explain something. Checking the score to make sure it's right. Well, it was 5-1 when he gave the 2 points to the back, so unless there was something we missed, I think it's going to stay 7-1. Biggerville is going to choose their choice. They're going to choose neutral.
Right. Well, after spending most of the last 4 minutes with the wrestler on his back, I don't know if he felt confident enough to start down there.
Well, he's in the area now where he can get a 4-point win for the team if he keeps the 8-point lead.
And down under a minute and a half. He's got.
He's working to turn him, and he just.
Yep.
And we got back points being counted again.
It's a matter of strength versus flexibility right now.
Yeah, the ref's holding 3 back points.
Getting close to 30 seconds left. And we have a
third period fall.
Yep.
For DeLone, DeLone's going to be up 6-0. Now you know that was an exhibition match.
Maybe we are starting at 106 because we do have a rather small.
Because they didn't put any points up, and it looks like everybody's going to line up here. They might have. Thanks, Danny.
Yeah, I think now we are going to have the introductions.
Wish I had a.
For the Squires at 113, Ryder Lee Regard.
Looks like we're having a couple forfeits in there.
Yeah.
At 138 for the Gainers, Kobe Fulton. For the Lones, Arnold Rugard. At 145 for the Gainers, Levi Haynes. For the Lones, Justin Haney or Tristan McCrovey.
Now, Levi Haynes is a real deal, right? He's pretty, he's really
at
good, state rated.
I think so.
Ethan Slayball. For the Squires, Dominic Giraffa. At 160 for DeLone, Jack Skovich. At 172 for DeLone, Tate Meter or Devin Reese. At 189 for the Canners, Levi Roberts, Sam Herta or Jacob Reed. For DeLone, Juan Stewart. At 215 for the Canners, Josh Fulton.
Now we recognize that name.
Yeah.
For the Canners, Jonathan Sanchez.
Josh was at the room, heck of a football player, too.
The head coach for Bakerville is Ken Haynes. The head coach for the Squires is Chad Giraffa. Your assistant coaches are Kevin Rafansky and Lucas Shaw. Your official placing name is Herb Jordan. At this time, we ask you to please rise.
We're going to have the national anthem, and we'll be back right after. We have the captains out here for the flip.
So it looks like we are starting at 160. That's still on the board there.
And we have a forfeit win here. I think that was Jack Skovich.
172.
This is Devin Reese coming out.
And another forfeit.
And now we have 189. Is that Fulton at 189?
I thought Fulton was 215, but he was announced at two different weights, so. I don't know who that is for the Squires out there.
Oh, that's Tate Neater.
Oh, was it Tate?
Yep.
He's going at 89.
Mm-hmm.
It might be Fulton then.
This promises to be a very good match. Now we have 2 points for a takedown. For Tate now settling in on 1:20 left.
Tate's looking to turn him out there.
Yeah, he's having some success.
Got him over.
And he's bridging out. But I think he might.
Thought he had him there anyway, but the ref's trying to get a look underneath there.
Okay, we do have a
pretty quick pin for Tate Meter.
Yeah,
just under a minute.
Yep, with just under a minute left, we have our final with a pin by Tate.
Well, this ain't Fulton, so. Going to have a match here at 2:15 also. Yeah,
we have Juan Stewart coming in for the Squires.
He played football too, didn't he?
Yes. Still jockeying for position. And now we have takedown by Biglerville.
And he's looking to turn also. Yeah, looks like he's going to get some back points here. The ref's on a count.
And we have a pin with 1:11 to go in the first.
49-second pin for the Biglerville wrestler. Makes it 18-6. And I think we do have a bout at heavyweight from what they announced here before the.
Yeah, I know Sam's heavyweight.
Sam Skovich?
Yep. And I did get some information. Biglerville does have no female wrestlers. They're all male.
Okay.
So there won't be any forfeits due to that. So everybody will hopefully get a chance to participate.
And good.
So at 2:85, we're going to start. About 20 seconds in, still waiting for, we're still looking for an opportunity. Takedown.
Takedown by
Biglerville. And looks like Sam's in trouble. He's bridging at the moment, but I think he's still going to be, yep. Still pinned.
That was 1:18 for the Biglerville. So the first five matches, two forfeits, three pins.
And pretty quick ones.
Just we'll go to the lightweight
now.
Yeah,
now we're going down to 106.
I don't know if Delone had
I don't think Delone had one. I think 113 with Ryder Lee was the was the smallest. We have
and that ties it up at 18-18. And we'll roll over to I think 13's next.
113.
Yeah, now at 113, we have Ryder Lee Recart coming out. One of our seniors from... Okay, so it looks like...
This is an exhibition match.
Right.
Between the 113-pound and the 106-pound, so it will not count. DeLone got a...
Yeah, they each got the forfeit for their weight class, but they're going to wrestle to experience it.
So no matter what happens here, it stays 24-18 right. After this match.
And this is only Ryder Lee's second year wrestling. I remember last year he was really, really effective, but he would have, you know, just the experience flaws. Yeah. But I think he's gotten, you know, he's catching up very quickly. We do have a takedown, though, for Biglerville as we go under a minute in the first round.
Yeah, I didn't think they would allow that too much longer.
So they're back in the middle, starting where they left off. Down about 30 seconds to go. Ryder's trying to sit out. But the Biglerville wrestler there is really keeping control. He got a hook in, as I don't know if they'd say that in wrestling, but in MMA, getting that left leg over top of the thigh of Recart. Now we finish this first period and go to the second with a score 2-0.
And Red defers, and that's going to give the call to DeLone here in the second period, and he's going to pick up. He wants on top.
Well, it looks like he has kept control.
Stall on green.
Might be getting. Nope, got his back down. But not close to. I think we have a. Nope, again, has him back down. Down under a minute in the second period. Still 2-0 Biglerville. Trying to turn him around. Nice shot from the other side, I believe. But the Biglerville wrestler's keeping a good wide base.
Hey, looks
and,
like
he's
and he's
going to get out. So that's going to be 3-0 after that. And we get to 20 seconds left. They're getting close to the... Now they're back in. In the waning seconds here, the second period. So going into the third period of our 113 match.
And Bigger Girl's going to choose neutral here. I thought he'd take down, but he'd choose neutral.
Well, he really only had a little bit of success getting out. He has taken down Ryder, so... And I'd be pretty, he might be confident that he can do it again. He hasn't been taken down yet.
Comes down to conditioning here, doesn't it, Coach, here in the third period?
It
was more of a trip.
Conditioning and experience, too.
Yeah.
And some of those work hand in hand. The more fatigued you are, the...
More the experience, because
the less you may remember. If you've been wrestling for a long time, you might have those things ingrained into you to the point where you're simply going to get to where you need to be when a less experienced fella might not.
1 minute left in the match.
I think we're getting out. We're going to start off and go back again into the middle.
Well, I think we have blood or something. I think we have blood time, Bill.
Yeah, we have a stoppage, I believe. I believe Ryder's bleeding. Looks like his left shoulder.
Either Ryder's bleeding or the Bigger Girl guy bled
on
Ryder.
It could have been his. Could have been
the nose of
nose,
the Bigger Girl
boy.
Yeah. Look over here. We got gold singlets coming on.
Yeah, I was anticipating some. I mean, now that once I saw them, I was getting a little relieved, so it'll be easier to tell who's who.
Well, Big Marville has the striped singlets, so that does make it easy.
It makes it easier. Having the stripe makes it easier.
Yeah, it does.
Doesn't make it easy.
But isn't it easier? Getting ready to resume the match. 50 seconds exactly left in this period.
Trying to turn Ryder over. I'm not sure. I mean, some of this is where the difference in size can be the difference too. He'll keep control, I think, but I don't think we'll be able to turn him over.
Well, he has 10 seconds. Looks like time's going to run out here before anything else happens.
Yep. Oh, they're out. But with an eighth of a second, I don't expect there to be any, position progress or any points. Okay. So again, that was an exhibition match between Biglerville's 106 wrestler and Delone's Ryderly Ricard at 113. So they both won their individual weight classes, but they had an exhibition match against each other to have the experience to wrestle.
Now we'll go to 120. And I think this might be a forfeit also.
And we have a forfeit now, so it's going to be 24.
110-126.
And we're beginning.
Who's that?
I just said we're beginning. This could be Bauerline.
I think it is. He was announced at 126. Just a mess out there now.
Yeah, they still haven't finished it. They're
got to get his head out to get two.
Yeah.
See how much I know about wrestling?
Yeah, you're pretty good. I mean, I might have a bit of an edge, but it's not much.
Yeah, I think once you got the head out there, you got the two.
Yeah, we have two now for DeLone. And just at a minute.
And now that bigger girl guy doesn't want to leave. He's just going to go. That was a nice exchange there for about 15 seconds. Nice roll through.
And they're out.
And they're out.
46.4 to go in the first period. Still not quite in as good a position as he was when they rolled out. So, I mean, there was still some advantage gained by the big girl wrestler rolling out, which is the point. But I think he's going to keep him down.
Bauerline's trying to get the turn. Can't get him far enough to get a count started, though. 10 seconds left.
Well, he does have him down in the back. I don't know if there's going to be anything.
No, but I think the ref's going to give him two or three back points here. Three. The ref wants a little bit of a consultation here.
Yeah, coach.
I think he'll say two, but I don't think he thought it was three. Coach Haynes, I think it's the head coach for Biggerville. They're going to leave it what it is.
That seemed pretty quick to get three, to be honest. But okay. I think just the fact that the move wasn't made to under 10 seconds.
Yeah.
But
looks like the loan has a little bit of blood problem over there. We'll start the second period. 5-0 DeLone, and DeLone's going down to start the second period here.
Now he's back to his feet, and they're really working, trying to lift.
Stalling on red.
Yeah, through 40 seconds now, there wasn't any. Still hasn't been
still
any
nothing
change
because
yet.
No
yeah,
change.
Because they're
a lot of action, but no change.
Yeah, it's and they're really working hard.
It's like Bauerline now turned him.
Now if he needs to get the head out again. Yep, now I think that's a reversal.
Also, three back points have been given, so it's going to be 10-0 at least if we don't pin him here. And he does.
That was really good. You know, they were going back and forth. It was a just about by both fellas, back and forth. But then when Connor finally got the head out there, was really close to a pin almost instantly. It's a very good match. Now we have 30-24. And as we go to about 132, I think.
32, yeah.
Yeah, we have Nate Hart coming out.
Well, this is Nate Hart, okay.
Yep. Another one of our seniors. And we're beginning again. A little bit less pressure on me now, it feels, now that I have a gold singlet and a black one out there. See, I'm just going on the way the wrestlers look. I think the Big Blue Rail wrestlers are younger.
The Hart's going to get
younger,
two
young
for
man.
A takedown. He's looking to turn here also. He's got to be careful with that arm.
Yeah. Yeah, that's okay.
Yeah, I think he took a little. Three back points for DeLone.
Now down under a minute.
He's going to start in that same arm.
You see, now he's going for, well, he was going for FLs, now he's. Oh, he has it.
Well, he has three back points. It looks like it.
Again, he's very
seconds.
Close. But
he's
man, he gets
pin.
To the pin.
First period pin. Minute and 47 in. DeLone has a 36-24 lead. And I think this is Levi Haynes coming out for Biggerville. May not be up. I shouldn't say that, but he was weighed in at 140. Oh, I'm sorry. It's 38. He might be 45. DeLone's actually going to send the rest out here at 38.
Down to 130 in the first.
DeLone wrestle. Going to get a takedown. Looking for a turn here.
He does just control that wrist now. He's got his right arm.
Try the other way. Getting back points now. And he's got
and
a pin.
We have a pin.
Do you know who that wrestler was? 42-24.
I don't know. I'm sorry.
Yeah.
With the mask and everything, it's even tougher to tell.
DeLone now will go to 45. So there's only two more matches left, 45 and 52. I'm not sure. Is DeLone sending anybody out here?
Yes. I think that's Justin Amy. Amy.
This might be Haynes now.
Oh, it's close, but no. Justin's in a bad spot. We're down only 30 seconds in, and he may.
Come on, Justin, work. Let's go. Okay.
Three back points. It's 5-0. Big to go. Turned again.
Now he does have that leg wrapped and comes back.
He's in trouble now.
Yeah, that was a nice protection from Biglerville wrestler, and now he got back in complete control, pretty complete control.
Three more back points makes it 8-0. And an escape for Justin Emmy. Points for Biggerville and a takedown.
And as we finish the first period, we're at 10-1. And
Justin Emmy said, I might as well stay up.
Yeah. Oh, man, you got it's very slick. Shooting right down to the ankle.
My guess is this is Haynes. Because he was weighed in at 45.
Yeah, he seems really, really skilled and that knows what he's doing. Not that Justin doesn't, but he's having a really tough time.
Going to get away and make it 12-2. Another takedown. See if he can turn him here.
And under a minute to go in the second.
He needs three back points to get us.
Technical fall.
Tech fall.
Going
into the third period here.
Yep. And we are.
Both wrestlers choose up again. I guess the bigger wrestler choose up.
Make it work. Make it work, kid. Make it work.
No. Third period pin. Forty-2-30. And there's one more match. This is the last match, I believe, Bill.
Yep. Back to 150.
So DeLone can't lose the match. I gotta win the match.
And I apologize for the frozen video feed. We're working on it. It is an unknown problem at the moment. May try to give a little bit more, play-by-play because I don't think the visuals are working. But they're still jockeying for position.
Do you know who the lone wrestler is?
I didn't see him start, so no.
John? I thought I heard somebody say John.
They're still both up. Now they're working on. Biggerville could be getting a takedown. This has to work on. Okay, I think they fall back up to standing position. So we still have with a minute to go in the first. No score yet, and both up on top, or both standing. And now the rings are coming back to the middle.
47 seconds left in the first period.
Again, still no score in this particular match. The total match score is 42 for DeLone and 30 for Biggerville. An attempt at a takedown by Biggerville didn't pan out. And just about out of the ring again with 20 seconds to go.
Rolled right out.
Very close to a takedown, but they were out of bounds, so they're going back to the beginning, back to the middle with 8 seconds to go. We'll see if anybody can. Well, nobody's still no score. The end of one. Biggerville wrestler chooses down position. And spinning around, I think he's got a reversal.
Yes, he did. Nice move.
Still in the middle of the ring. Trying to kind of cradle him over. Working on the cradle completely, turned
him
over, and he got it.
Got a pin. That's going to do it.
Yep.
So DeLone's going to win the match 42-36. I think that's it.
Yep.
Yeah, 42-36, they're waving at each other the way right. They do it now in COVID. So, Bill, tomorrow night we'll be back here for the DeLone Squires and Littlestown Thunderbolts in a boys basketball game. JV game starts at 6, varsity immediately after. We'll be here along with Mike Knoll tomorrow night to bring you that.
Yep. And again, we have 42-36 win by DeLone. Thanks, everybody. On behalf of my wife, Danny, here on tech, and Tony helping me with commentary. Good night, everyone.